Now let's talk for a minute about rapper classes. And when I'm talking about rapper classes, I'm not talking about boy, you should have known by now, Spencer does it. That's not what we're talking about. We're talking about rapper classes, WRAPPER classes, rapper classes. And these are useful when we have information of one type that we want to convert to another type. And so let me go ahead and create a class here. Rapper class fun. Okay, so if we have information that, I'll go ahead and import the Java util class, util scanner class, and then set up an instance of a scanner. So scanner in equals new scanner system in. And then if I read in some data, so I'm going to get information as a string. I'll just call it input equals blank to begin with. So I say system.out.println, and I say something like, please enter the year you were born. Okay. And I read that into the input. Okay, so input equals in.next, and because it's a string, it's going to be a next line, right? Or a next, I guess we could do. So now we've stored that information. Okay, so if I print this out, system.out.println, let's just print what we read in, make sure everything came in okay. So I'll save this. Okay. That's the information we get out is a string, okay? What then if I wanted to calculate at what age, if I enter another year, so let's go to something easier, 2000, and if I want to calculate the age that I become an adult, so 18 years after I'm born. The problem is if I calculate that age, so let's say I create an int called adult age and set that equal to 0 to begin with. If after I've read in this information, I want to do a calculation. So I want to take that input, which was way too generic of a name, I should have given it a better name, and set it adult age, and set it equal to whatever the input was plus 18. It's going to tell me incompatible types. This is a string or words or characters. Even if I entered a number like 2000 into this input, it's still considered letters because it's in a string. It's characters, I guess I should say. It's not a number. It's ASCII characters. And so I can't add 18 on. That doesn't make any sense. What does A plus F equal? It doesn't make sense, right? So in order to make this into a number so that I can do something with it, first of all, I could just declare it as a number and then read it in as a next int. But we also have available to us these wrapper classes. And the wrapper classes work like this. If I want to turn this input into an integer, then there's an integer class that has a parse int method in it that I pass a string. So and it's integer.parseInt, and then I pass it a string, okay? And that will go into the string and try and create a number out of it, okay? So if I do this now, and I enter the year 2000, Well, the problem is I'm printing out input still. Let me print out instead adult age. Let's try that. Okay, and now I say 2000. Then now it'll print out 2018 because it parsed an integer out of the input and then it added 18 onto it, and that's what we get for the age. So adult age is 2018. Wouldn't it have been convenient to have been born in the year 2000? It'd be so easy to calculate everything. Okay, what if I enter something like hi? Well, I get an error because hi is not something that I can parse an integer out of. And we'll talk about catching these errors later on so that it doesn't just crash the program like it just did. What if I say hi 2000? Well, same problem. What if I say 2000 hi? Same problem. But if I enter something that is potentially an integer, so if I'd been born in the year 1950, then it tells me that I would be an adult in 1968. And we use that by, again, using these wrapper classes, integer.parseInt. There's a long.parse, guess it, long, yeah. Integer.parseLong. There's a float.parseFloat. There's a double.parseDouble. If I wanted to take this and make it a double, well, I'll get an error. But just to show you, double.parse, instead of parseInt, that wouldn't make any sense. It's going to be the parseDouble. So I double.parseDouble. Again, double being the class, parseDouble being the method. It's going to tell me possible loss of precision because now it's adding a double onto an int and then trying to store it into an int. So I can make this a double, or I can cast this double as an int, right? Remember how to do that? In parentheses, we put that keyword int, and that says make whatever comes next an integer. And now it'll work just fine. And now we get a double out of there. Now why I did that, just to show you, that doesn't make any sense to do a double and then just cast it back to an int. Wouldn't I have just done an int in the first place? But these wrapper classes are very useful. In fact, I'm aware of individuals, and this is a fairly common thing, that will read everything in as a string and then just parse out what they need to, rather than reading it in as an integer. And really, I guess it just depends on the situation, but that is a possibility. On the other hand, we can go the other way. We can take an integer, adult age, and make that a string by saying, let's take that adult age now, and so I better create one more variable, string output. And I can say output is going to be equal to integer dot to string, and then pass it the adult age, which is a integer that I've just calculated. Okay, so remember, adult age is an integer. I'm going to say in that integer class there's a toString method that will take whatever's in the integer and make it into a string, and that's what I'm going to set my output to, and then I can print out the output. Now this isn't going to look any different, so this is kind of a stupid example, and I know what you're saying. Most of these examples are stupid. That's true. There we get our 2018, but instead of being a number, it's actually a string. Okay, if I try and say output plus 5, it's going to yell at me and say, it's not going to yell at me, but notice it didn't do the math. It just tacked the 5 onto the end because now it's all treated as text. Okay, does that make sense? All right, very good. So these are what we refer to as wrapper classes, and they're very useful to see and these are just some of them, right? If we go back to where's our window? If we go back to our window and say Java integer class, then here's going to be the information about the integer class. So here's the integer class. There's some fields, and then here's all the methods we can do. We can do a bit count, byte value, compare to, decode, and for any of these, we can go click on them and go look at the details. So the parse int method takes a string and parses the string argument as a signed decimal integer. The characters in the string must be all decimal digits, except the first character may be an ASCII minus. So you can have a minus in there if you're doing a negative number. So it gives you a little bit of information. Again, this is like the instruction manual. This API is the instruction manual for how to use these methods. And there are just a ton of them out there. So you can. So in other words, I guess what I'm getting at is I didn't go through like a comprehensive view of all of the methods that are part of the integer class or any of the wrapper classes, but rather giving you an example of how they might work. And everything we're doing here is like adding a tool to our tool belt. So at some future point, when we've got a string and we're trying to turn it into an integer, we say, that's right, there was a thing to do that. What was it? And we remember what we were supposed to do and then go and get that tool out of our tool belt and implement it. So I'm just kind of feeding you the tools here with what we're doing. And so that's wrapper classes. And the bad news in all of this is now that I'm so far into this video, it's too late to go back and change that ridiculous intro. So it lives on in history. With that, I'm going to say Spencer out.